Welcome back. So we were looking at the different addressing modes of the processor. And so let's look at the next addressing mode, indirect addressing mode. So in indirect addressing mode, the memory address is provided. However, this address is indirect. So this is not the actual address of the operand. It is the address of the location at which the address for the operand is stored. So I think the execution will make it look very clear. So this is the data memory. So the memory address given in the operand field here. Now this is not the actual address of the operand. It is used to access some certain location. Now here the address is present. And this address is used to fetch the operand from the same memory. So this is the indirect addressing. The expression is nothing but effective address is address stored at the location of given by the address specified in operand field. The advantage of this system is the large address space is given. So now you can have the address stored. So in fact, the size of the data memory decides the address space here. So it's very useful. The only disadvantage is there are multiple memory references. So for each instruction in such format, we are going to have two memory references. It slows the operation. So let's look at the next addressing mode, which is nothing but register indirect addressing mode, in which the register contains the address of the operand from the memory, and the address of this register is given in the operand field. So let's look at the execution. So we are using both register file and data memory here. So the register address is provided, then data from that register is fetched, and the data is nothing but the effective address of the operand from data memory. So finally, the operand is fetched from the data memory using that address. So the expression can be the memory address stored at R. Okay, so that is the effective address of operand. Now this R is nothing but the register address which is given in the operand field. The advantage of this mode is that there is large address space present, and the disadvantage again is that there is extra memory reference here. So register file is also accessed and data memory is also accessed. So this is the disadvantage of this addressing mode. Now let's look at the next addressing mode, that is displacement addressing mode. In this, operand field is divided in two parts. The register address is given and the memory address is also given. Now here the memory address is not the address of the operand. In fact, in this, the memory address is acting as the base address, and the value at the register is added to this base address to calculate the actual effective address of the operand. So let's quickly look at the implementation of this. So here is the R. R is used to access the particular register from the register file. Now the value from the register is added to the memory address to calculate the actual effective address of the operand. So this type of execution is used where the segmentation is used in the memory, or different base registers are present inside the memory organization. So again, this addressing mode varies according to the organization of the processor. So the general expression is given by the effective address is calculated by the address specified in the instruction plus the value of the register that is addressed by R. So this is the expression. The advantage of this system can be it has very flexible mapping. So the basically different types of mappings can be implemented using such addressing mode. The only disadvantage is, I think it's very clear so far, so it's very complex to implement and to understand this kind of displacement addressing mode. However, this addressing mode is used in various processor organizations due to its flexibility and the large address space. The last addressing mode that we are going to see is nothing but the implicit addressing mode. In this implicit addressing mode, there is no operand specified in the instruction. The operand is implicit to the particular instruction. So opcode is sufficient in this kind of instruction. So for example, we are going to take here the stack instruction like pop and push. We know that these kind of stack instructions are always going to refer to the top of the stack. So there is no need to specify the particular operand. They are directly hardwired inside the system. So this is the very simple mode. So effective address is nothing but a stack pointer for this example. So we know that pop or push is always going to access the stack pointer. So there is no need to specify in the instruction. So finally, the advantage is, again, no memory references are required in such instruction. And the disadvantage is limited applications. Now, such addressing mode can be present for only certain instructions, like we saw the stack instructions or rather some specific instruction where very few instructions are there where the registers or the operands are implicit. So this addressing mode has very limited applications. So that's all about the different addressing mode present inside the processor. Now these addressing modes can vary from the organization to organization, and different processors are going to have different addressing modes in them. So I hope you have got the general idea of which addressing modes are present and what is the significance of them inside the CPU organization. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.